Hey guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. So this is gonna be a quick, super simple, super basic MyFitnessPal tutorial on how to use it. So let's get started right away. Let's just get to it. So you can download this app on your iPhone for free in the App Store. You don't have to pay for it, completely for free. And let's just get to it. So I've had mine since 2015, so a lot of my settings, I mean, a lot of information is already in there, but I believe you just input like your name, your goals and stuff. So you're gonna go to goals. So this is the tab I use, goals, and it lets you put in your weight, what you your goal weight is and what you're trying to lose, and I guess it helps you. But I never really used it for that reason. I've always had like my calories and macros already calculated, and I just use it for this right here. So you're gonna go to nutrition goals, calorie, carbs, protein, and fat goals. So let's say these are my calories. Like I said, this is from like 2015, so don't copy this. This is an old phone. Calories, let's say these are my calories. That's how much carbs I'm eating, 136, protein and fat. So let's say you need to change these numbers. You would just click on the tab. And since this is the free option, it's not really gonna let you move this around. It only lets you stick to like a certain percentage, which is fine. That is totally fine, because you know in your head what carbs, protein, and fat in grams you need to hit. So that's fine. I would just keep it that way. This just kind of roughly helps you estimate where you need to be. So then I would save it. I would go back. That's, like I said, that's all I really use from this app. Then let me help you input your food. So let's go to tomorrow, since I already started today. Let's start a new one. So this is your calories to start off. So let's say I need to add my breakfast. And the cool thing is at the beginning, it's a little bit annoying because you do have to type in all your food. But the more you type in the same food, it ends up saving it. So all you need to do eventually is just click on the food you're eating. And if you eat the same food usually during the week, then it becomes super fast and quick. So I had 3 egg whites. So I already have it in there. 3 egg whites, click it. I had 6 almonds with my oats. See, I already have it. You can change the serving size. So you can do so much. So serving size, 1 almond, number of servings, 6. So I had 6 almonds, save. Then I had, I always have unsweetened almond milk throughout the day in my coffee and oats. So I usually estimate a cup. Since I'm not prepping for a show or bodybuilding, this is not like super strict, like I'm not really trying to like lose weight, you know, it's not like urgent or you're following like a certain meal plan, then it's okay to kind of roughly estimate. That's the cool thing about flexible dieting. You know, it's not like a do or die, like it's, you can't really mess it up, I feel. All right, and then I had 1 egg. So I'm gonna actually show you how to find this. So let's pretend you need to search for a new food. So let's just type in egg. You would search and then see. So you just, eventually you end up noting, I mean, you end up knowing how much calories are in each food item. So I already know that usually 1 egg is 70 calories. So I would just click whichever one I want. So eggs, 1 egg, save it. So that, let's say that's my breakfast for today. But the other cool thing is if you're feeling a little lazy, you're on the go, you just wanna scan the item, something new, it has this option where you add food and then it has this barcode right here. So you would click the barcode and all you do is scan the food. So I have my Quest protein right here and I'm gonna show you by scanning it with the phone. It doesn't have a case, so it's like super slippery. So let's see. Oops, I didn't show you guys. Let me do it again. I wasn't recording that. Okay, so let's barcode right there. Let me bring the phone. Let's follow the phone. Sorry, it's hard to record in. See, it scanned it right there. Perfect. So then now I have my vanilla protein powder. It gives you all of the information, how many carbs, fat, protein, serving size, 1 scoop. But once you get into this rhythm, guys, you can start doing weird stuff. Like when I do my protein waffles, I only use like 10 grams of protein. or I only use like half a scoop. So today I've only had, I don't think I'm gonna have like a full scoop, so I'm gonna change the serving size. So half a scoop, number of serving size, half. And it calculates it for you. So it brings it down. And you just save it, and that's that. So super easy, super simple. I made this video for my peeps. I don't like to call them clients, but I am coaching a couple people right now, and they're learning how to use my Fitness Pal. So I wanted to create this video for them, but I said, why not just upload it on YouTube and help the world? One other tip I wanna give you is, like, let's say you're eating out, and you don't, you know, when you eat out, guys, you do have to be careful because there's a lot of hidden calories. So let's say you have like a favorite restaurant and you know what you're gonna get. Let's say you're going to Chili's. So Chili's, you would just type Chili's right here. And it gives you, like, people already inputted their meals in here. So a lot of these are people that already did it on their own manually. So you do wanna compare the calorie. If you wanna go the extra mile, you can go on their website, but I'll talk about that on another video. But let's say you got the mango chili chicken. So you would add that to your meal, I mean to your day. But see, it gives you like all the insight. Calories, 520, fat, 17 grams, carbs, 66, and protein, 38. So that's like a lot for a meal, especially if you're on low calories. And then it even gives you some tips, like the amount of sodium it is. And it gives you like little tips, like your fat is pretty high. So my Fitness Pal does a good job. But then it gives you an insight, guys, like why eating out isn't the greatest sometimes, because you can easily wrap up like 1,000 calories in one meal. Let's say you had a dessert or soda and drink, you easily already ate 1,000 calories in one meal. And if you're trying to lose weight, that is gonna hinder your progress. So that's it. I hope I didn't miss anything on here. If you have any questions, definitely comment down below. I do have my email posted on the description box. If you are interested in nutrition plans or coaching, I am taking on a couple more clients right now. I'm sharing my postpartum journey. Definitely give this video a like, please share and subscribe. And I do appreciate all the love that everybody has been giving me. And I hope this was useful for you guys. I hope I didn't miss anything. But yeah, thank you for watching. Bye. This is supposed to be a thumbs up.